is about a bridge in the form of chloride-induced corrosion. The bridge was built in the center of Portugal, in the seaside, is only 500 meters away from the sea. This is a view, a picture taken on the bridge to the sea, so to have an idea how close the sea is was the bridge. The bridge was built in 1970. It's a small bridge, 60 meters long, and the owner was a public institution, but not focused in bridges, it's water services, but for different reasons they have some small bridges, and it is important for the old case. Because during many years the bridge has no maintenance and no inspections at all. So, some years ago, 2004, during an inspection, the situation was really, really bad. We have cracking, but especially huge problems with the corrosion, as you can see here. After that, some tests was carried out in order to check the termination of concrete cover, measure carbonation dip, corrosion potential, and the corrosion rate. And the results were also not good. I mean, the probability of corrosion is very high in all the bridge. Some cores were taken in order to do some laboratory tests, and the focus of the tests were the chloride content of concrete, carbonation, the compressive strength, and also to do some microscope analysis. And as you can see, the chloride penetration was already very, very important. So, taking into account the advanced state of degradation and the very deep penetration of chlorides, the bridge replacement was recommended. After that, some inspections was also taken, and the situation was worse. Even worse, naturally. So, in 2010, the owner decided to replace the bridge, but at that time, the question is, it will be safe to keep the bridge in service until the new one be ready to use. So that was the question, and in. For check the this problem, safety of the bridge, the critical limit state was the bending at mid-span section of the central beam of the left beam. The left beam was the beam in the seaside, so the degradation was much it's worse in the bridge than in the others. According to the Portuguese national code that was used for the design in the design of the bridge was unsafe. Using a target reliability index of 3.8 and doing a probabilistic analysis based on the prior information and considering all these basic variables, the result was the same. The bridge was not safe because the reliability index was lower than the target one. So, a susceptibility analysis was carried out, and the result was this. I mean, the most important variable was the residual section index. I mean, the area of reinforced bar that remains after the corrosion that really happened. So the idea was to collect more information about the residual areas of reinforcement. For that purpose, measurements were carried out in the reinforced bars that already was already exposed, but also some small windows were opened in order to check it. And the difference was this one. I mean, this is the model of the residual section index with the prior information, and after the new data, we have this one. And after this, with the new probabilistic variation, we get a relativity index higher than the target, and the problem was solved. I mean, the bridge was maintained in service until the destruction, the construction of the new one, and after that, the bridge was demolished. This is the new bridge. Now, in 60 seconds, as just to remind the problem. The problem was the bridge with a high degradation level. And some lab tests proved that the problem was a chloride-induced corrosion. The bridge replacement was decided, and the question at the time was, is the bridge safe until replacement? Using code-based safety assessment, the bridge was unsafe, and using a probabilistic approach, only with prior information, the result was the same. In this point that I started applying our approach, I mean, and the result of at that time of the problem was doing a sensitivity analysis in order to see what were the variables most important to circle safety, and then collect information about the one that was really important, the residual section index, and doing another analysis of this new information, and which was considered safe. So, this is the flow chart. Yes. And the main problem, the main objective was to guarantee the safety of the bridge. So the decision, was to keep it in service or close it at once. So this is where, but it's somewhere here. And this is the focus. I mean, the decision is very clear. And, yes or no? I mean, yes or no, it's possible to keep it in service with traffic restraint constraints. Or
but the consequences here have been the costs or the disadvantage not to have a bridge until it's rebuilt, right?
This so is the data I don't have yet.
Yeah, but there we have to make assumptions.
Yes, yes, yes.
User costs.
Yes.
And then there's a technical question for the reliability analysis. Did you, so this reinforcement bars, you tested their intention, right?
Mm-hmm.
So then yes. You used the extreme value distribution or the extreme corrosion pit?
Yes.
Just depend on the length, or you did these considerations?
I'm sorry, the considerations or what?
So you measured this cross-sectional
in different situations.
Variability.
Yes.
What is important is to know the spot where we have the most
I measure in different situations. I mean, with the exposed and very degraded bars, and I measure with exposed but not with no not so high level of degradation, and I measure also in the windows open to that this proposed. And that in general, in the measurements, the bars was almost perfect.
Mm-hmm. And in your a priori analysis, what did you assume
in
for
the
this corrosion loss?
50%. I mean, there are two levels. Mm-hmm. Two levels in the bottom reinforcement bars. There are two levels, mm-hmm. and I admit that the upper level is 100% okay,
yeah.
and the other is 50%.
Yeah, because there we already have to make a probabilistic statement. So in this a priori analysis, that's actually then a good idea to consider this corrosion loss as a random variable.
Yes.
Yeah, and give this random variable a rather high uncertainty because you're not sure about it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's then what you update with your measurements.
Yes. It's here. Yes.
Yeah.
So the measurements was was visual inspection and
the measurement was like this.
So it's mainly visual inspection
and. Yeah, it was this graph you showed.
Mm.
Yeah, I remember the graph. But I think all the extreme value distribution, bipolar distribution.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's about the minimum, right?
Yes.
The minimum cross section is such. And then, of course, you have a variability in the tension stress, this reinforcement bars.
Yes.
So somehow, so it's mechanically it's very.
Yes, but the critical section was the mid span section. So the analysis was about the safety or not was about. That section only. Mm. Okay.
So yeah, but you have
variability.
I agree that
yes.
you have a cross section where you have the maximum mm-hmm. moment mm-hmm. and the maximum
yes.
stresses, but you can have the max. So it's not so easy, right?
No.
So you can also have a very severe corrosion close to the mid span.
Yes.
Which is then the size.
Yes, of course. It's the same.
Yeah.
Okay, but. Probabilistic modeling, there's several interesting aspects, but let's take the decision scenario.
Yes.
So, so what you have done so far now is not a decision analysis. We are working with reliabilities and
mm-hmm.
basically thresholds.
Mm-hmm. Next step.
So, what are we after with the decision analysis? The most efficient way of, I think this is what you are after, the most efficient way of measuring and getting the structure safe. So that's why you did the sensitivity analysis.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But it's only a reliability, but a value of information analysis is characterized by the type, that's exactly what you are after. It's the type, it's the precision. The type is the relevance, that's the sensitivity analysis. It's the precision, how precise your technology is. And it's the costs. And and there may also be, so the high sensitivity was clearly the residual cross-section area, which if you look to the sensitivity, yep, this one. So this is clearly the highest sensitivity. I think it's a good idea on a reliability basis, but then it's just the precision and the type. Or no, this is about the type. The precision goes in here, and also the costs. And it could be also that. The reinforcing steel strength
yes.
theoretically could be that this is cheaper. Yeah.
No.
No. Yeah. Okay.
No, because
but
no. Mm, no. I mean.
Yeah.
We know at the time the type of the steel used, okay. But we don't have bars out of the circuit to
yes.
It's
more complicated.
So it's more complicated.
Yeah. Okay.
And the measurement of the section was quite
okay.
easy.
Okay.
So in your case, you have these measurements of the section.
And especially the reinforced bars.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And you want all these case studies about the value of measuring this area in order to.
The value of all this process, I mean, the additional information.
The additional information is about
the bridge remain in service until the new one. So the value was
the update of the reliability
yes.
based on the measure of the cross section.
Yes, yes. The experimental data was
the measurement of the cross section. Okay.
Okay. In general, we need to speed up, but let's. Try to get to the point where we have a clear decision analysis. I think it's very good engineering. You are overviewing and you are having the focus on most important things. And maybe it's this problem. You are completely overviewing. You don't have to do a decision analysis.
No, but yes, I try to think at the time of to take the decision in 2010. You have to take the decision to keep the bridge in service or close it.
Yeah, that's
the point.
That's the decision on the system, and then the decision on the possible measurement actions is: should I measure or not?
Yes.
So you set yourself into the point of 2010.
Yes.
And then you need the cost of these additional measurements. And the effect on the reduction on salt field,
yes.
And then
it can
be done.
Yes,
Yes, surely.
But
yes.
In the back view.
Yes, surely also in the back view. And here's it would be better if there was an alternative measurement, which is more costly, for instance. Because Luis, you're completely overviewing the situation, and you most probably have found the best way to do already.
You can compare the proof loading. Interesting,
yes.
And then you also have the risk that you destroy the bridge. The proof is actually interesting.
Okay, this would be very interesting. Yeah. Okay. I think it's a very good case. The decision should be in 2010. And this is one way, and maybe proof loading could be another way.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. That's good. Which we cannot overdo.
Okay.
So easily. Okay, super. Thanks.